Hey, what's up out there, families? This one is not just about your kids. It is about all of you in that family unit, because all of us, man, are so overrun by our busy schedules and this one word called stress in today's world. So we're going to talk about the number one nerve that we should all be talking about. Now, I just don't mean we should be talking about this amazing, incredible nerve because we're neuro nerds. Maybe you don't hang out at neurology parties like I do with nerdy, neurologically focused pediatric and family chiropractors. But I bet you talk about stress a lot in your life. I bet you talk a lot in your life about how tired you are. I bet you talk a lot in your life about how quite often your kids seem to be very tired and very emotional and very cranky. And all of these things are a very regular part of our life. You actually probably really actually nerd out a little bit over it in today's world, more so than we did even just 5 years ago, because I bet a bunch of you are wearing an Apple Watch and you're measuring your stress levels and making sure to close your rings and getting little alerts about, hey, heart rate's a little elevated there, my friend. Might want to take a break instead of another quad latte from Starbucks. Maybe you wear a Garmin. Maybe you wear a Whoop. Maybe you sleep with your Aura ring at night. I love all of these things. I measure my health, my performance, my well-being, without a doubt, by tapping into this nerve called the vagus nerve. So there we are. What was I, a minute or two into the introduction before we said the name of the number one nerve we should all be talking about? V-A-G-U-S. Not Las Vegas. Now, if you go to Las Vegas, you will absolutely lose track of your vagus nerve, because your vagus nerve is in charge of rest, digestion, and you're going to see here in a little bit, proper decision making. So actually, if you were to go to Las Vegas with a properly functioning vagus nerve, maybe you could digest all the food from the buffet. Maybe you would choose to go to bed at 9 o'clock at night instead of 9 a.m. And maybe your vagus nerve would help your brain function. You would make better decisions and not donate all your money to the casinos. But this video is not about joking and making bad, really lame vagus nerve to Las Vegas correlations like I just did. This video is actually talking about the three things you need to know about the vagus nerve that are very super practical and applicable to your life and to your kid's life, and you probably don't know. So here we go. Number one, the vagus nerve does a lot more. If you've heard of it, you've probably heard of it as the rest and digest nerve. Now, it's crazy. Medical doctors, other professionals in healthcare, like we all, no matter our initials, should be experts in the vagus nerve, because what all sorts of leading neuroscience research and really just practical understanding of how we are wired and where our health comes from has everything to do with the nervous system and everything to do with the vagus nerve and whether it's functioning and has what's called variability, resiliency, and adaptability to it. See, our vagus nerve doesn't just do rest, help us sleep or calm down, or digest, help our lunch and the healthy salad you had at lunch make its way through. The vagus nerve does a lot more than that. So what I want to do is jump on over to my favorite nerdy whiteboard iPad and show you what the vagus nerve really does, so you can see it visually that it has lots of jobs. And if we are exhausting and running low on our vagus nerve function, you're about to see not just your sleep and your digestion will be challenged, but so many other things as well. This applies to us and this applies to our kids. So yes, let's put the first one on there. So the first thing the rest and digest nerve does is it helps us rest. It helps us sleep. It slows our heart rate down. It slows our breathing down. So it's really kind of the rest, sleep, meditation nerve. Most of you have downloaded 17 different meditation apps on your phone and never used any of them because you're so bad at resting, because your vagus nerve is so tapped out. So if you're struggling with sleep and you've tried magnesium and melatonin and maybe even sleep medications, well, the vagus nerve is the answer to your sleep challenges. Keep listening and keep learning about how to tap into it and get it working better when we get to the end of this video and we're done talking about all of its jobs and the things, where it gets injured and how to help it. So it's first in charge of rest. Second, yes, it's in charge of digest. So that is really what we talk about in terms of motility. And you know what? Let's just put it on there. The word at the end of the day is the end of the tunnel is that word, poop. And so many kids are struggling with sleep, a very crucial basic health pillar, and then they're struggling with digestion as well. In infants, it looks like colic and reflux and upset stomachs, and then a lot of time it's constipation and all of those things as well. So a lot of adults, a lot of teenagers are struggling with sleep, and they're struggling with digestion and upset stomachs and constipation, and the vagus nerve getting it back online is the answer to getting those things back online as well. But now what we also know what the vagus nerve does is it also controls our immune system, and specifically the modulation and the control of inflammation. See, the vagus nerve is actually the number one most important and potent nerve for what's called the parasympathetic nervous system. Lots of nerdy words there. Para means the opposite of the sympathetic system. The sympathetics are our fight or flight, rage, anger, tension, stress. So when we are stuck in fight or flight response and we're in this protective response, we're not sleeping, we're wound up. We're not digesting because we want to save that energy from our digestive system and the muscles in there, called smooth muscles, for the muscles out here because we might need to fight or we might need to flight. And also, when we are in fight or flight sympathetic dominance, meaning our vagus nerve is not activated, not working, we're not really worried about the common cold or the flu or those things because we think we're about to have some wounds and have some real battles. So our vagus nerve is in charge of helping regulate inflammation and regular immune responses, and it can't do its job if we're stuck in fight or flight all the time. So if you have chronic allergies, chronic immune challenges, chronic autoimmune challenges, you need to know all about the vagus nerve. Now, if we really go into the kid department and the developing brain and pediatric world, what we now know about the vagus nerve too is that the sensory communication components of the vagus nerve really help us with our socialization and our communication, so social and speech. The vagus nerve is a sensory nerve. Actually, let's just add that one in here on its own. So if your child struggles with sensory issues at all, interference and malfunction, do what they call subluxation or dysfunction of the vagus nerve, is probably really at play, leading to them having so many sensory challenges with clothes or noise or foods or different things, and they get sensory overwhelm and meltdowns and tantrums. Then they're not gonna get into social and speech development. The other thing we know about the vagus nerve is, again, you can kind of see how I'm drawing this out. These things go south, right? So they slow our they help our digestion, they slow our heart rate, they help our immune system. This is all stuff, we'll call it north into the brain, sensory and neurological processing, socialization and speech, so regulating different parts of the brain, and then also our emotional regulation or mood. You could call that behavior. The vagus nerve is really, really in charge of calming our mood, getting us out of these panic and anxiety and wound up worlds that we live in. And finally, there's another branch of the vagus nerve that really has a lot to do with our learning, our cognition, our focus, and memory. And so if you're feeling like you have brain fog all of the time, it could be that your vagus nerve is tapped out. So that's going to take me the longest part of this video, is number one thing that you didn't know but need to know about the vagus nerve is it does a lot more than just rest and digest. It does all of those things, which is why one problem with one thing called the vagus nerve can create what unfortunately we see in the vast majority of our patients, even kids today, is a multitude of chronic illnesses. Most sick kids and sick people don't have one or two conditions. They've got a multitude of conditions, and they have all these different specialists and all these different medications and all these different approaches to try and work on one thing, when it's actually the nervous system and the vagus nerve that ties all those things together. So the vagus nerve is the key to so many different woven together illnesses, chronic especially, which means it's also the key and the answer and the drug-free solution to getting through so many things. Digestive issues, sleep issues, immune issues, inflammation issues, social-emotional issues, communication issues, sensory processing issues, mood, behavior, and emotional dysregulation issues, and also focus and cognition and brain function and recognition. So the vagus nerve online doing its job means the body can do all of the incredible jobs that God designed it to do. And it's a lot. You think you have a lot to do on your to-do list every day. Try me in the vagus nerve. All right. So here's the deal. What are the other two things? We're not done with this video yet, because you got to understand what damages the vagus nerve and then how to fix it and how to take care of it. So the number two and the number three thing to know about the vagus nerve is, number two, it's easily damaged by birth trauma. So getting into the anatomy really quick, and I just wrote words on the iPad there. I can't draw pictures very well, so I'm not going to go back to the iPad. Just going to have you sort of charade, I'll charade this out for you. The vagus nerve is actually a cranial nerve. Now this is our cranial system, our head, our skull, our noggin. So the cranial nerves really branch from the brainstem. They come off of the spinal cord brainstem area, because really the brainstem and the brain just become the spinal cord. It's all the same. We just call it different things for anatomical purposes, so nerds like me can take tests through all the years of school we go through. But the nervous system is one continuous system from the what we call prefrontal cortex all the way through our brain, into the middle brain, into the what we call primal or brainstem, down the spinal cord, spinal nerves. The nervous system is interconnected, free-flowing, and it's supposed to function without interference. And what happens with forceps and vacuum and C-section deliveries is that we really damage and we interfere because of all the twisting, the pulling, the trauma, the neuromuscular tension, and the inflammation and the irritation caused to the brainstem area by birth trauma. The vagus nerve is easily and often injured via birth trauma, and it is the number one missing link in all of pediatric healthcare. If you think probiotics and the microbiome are a big deal, you should continue to learn about the vagus nerve and birth trauma and this thing called subluxation and dysautonomia, because that is really the root cause of nearly every single condition we see come into our clinic. And the link that triggers this subluxation, triggers this vagus nerve dysfunction and shutting it down and limiting its function, and the whole what we call perfect storm, is almost always birth trauma. And if we swim upstream a little bit, stress during the pregnancy, fertility challenges, those also really start to exhaust the vagus nerve. Because the third thing to know about the vagus nerve, whether we're a brand new baby and a little kid or a grown up like us, is the vagus nerve is easily worn out and exhausted by the stressful, chronic, high pace, high toxin, highly chaotic environment and lifestyle we live in. The vagus nerve is our brake. Okay. The fight or flight system is our gas pedal. We need our gas pedal. You got stuff to do during the day. You're going to go for a workout. The sympathetic fight or flight system is not a bad system. We need it for protection. We need it for survival. We need it for day-to-day activity. But we're supposed to regulate and balance things out with our vagus nerve and with this modulation or with this governor that the vagus nerve does. Most of us live such a high-paced, high-stress lifestyle that we just can't possibly expect our vagus nerve to keep up. We're trying, right? You're trying sleep apps, magnesium, melatonin, yoga classes, meditation, everything else. But maybe you still feel like there's a huge gap there between your nervous system being wound up all the time and worn out because you can't recover, you can't restore, you can't have that resiliency and the adaptability because your vagus nerve is tapped out. Whether you've been through a ton of stress or a little bit of stress, measuring your health by measuring the health of the vagus nerve is the number one thing that will change your life. Now, I referenced earlier the Apple Watch, the Garmin, the Oura Ring, Whoop, those sort of things. They're fantastic. I'm a huge fan of them. I'm wearing my Garmin right now, and I keep track of my vagus and my body battery on there all the time. These are not near as effective or accurate measurements of vagal nerve function and what's called heart rate variability, as is the inside scans that we run in our office and all PX docs in our network have. The HRV scan is the single biggest scan we can do for a baby, because we can clip it under their ear, clip it under their pinky or to their toe, or onto their finger, and we can just have parents and teenagers and everybody can run an HRV in a matter of 3 to 5 minutes, and we can tell whether your vagus nerve is online and doing its job, or whether your vagus nerve is tapped out, worn out, and not doing its job. And once you find out if it's tapped out and worn out, then we can sit down with you and build a customized care plan to tap into that vagus nerve, to recharge it, restore it. The coolest thing ever is the most potent, incredible vagus nerve activating, kick in the pants sort of move you can ever do is one you don't even have to do. You just show up to your pediatric, neurologically focused, or again, if you're an adult, family chiropractor, lay on the table. If you get neurofocused chiropractic adjustments, which is a different kind of chiropractic than your regular average bear chiropractic done in a van down by the river, just kidding, don't go to that chiropractor. Just if you've watched, sorry, little Tommy Boy reference there. Not Tommy Boy, but okay, I'm lost. The biggest thing is to find your HRV and find a pediatric and family chiropractor who is neurologically focused, because yes, you can meditate. Yes, you can go for a walk in nature. Yes, you can take deep breaths. Yes, you can take melatonin. But I bet you've tried a bunch of that. And the truth is, a lot of that is not as potent as the right kind of chiropractic adjustments that know exactly how to tap into the vagus nerve, reactivate it, restore it, recharge it. It's my favorite thing, which is why I'm still talking on this video, because I can't get enough of talking about the vagus nerve, HRV, and neurologically focused chiropractic. Because whether you are an adult like me who's got four kids and a lot to do, and you want to charge hard but not run out, get your vagus nerve activated with chiropractic adjustments on the regular. Or whether you're a baby who's in charge of eating, sleeping, pooping, and looking cute, you need your vagus nerve. If you're a grade schooler who needs to socialize, communicate, learn, you need your vagus nerve. If you're a teenager, whew, not an easy time in life. They need their vagus nerve at full power. I hope this video helped you out a ton. We have an incredible article, multiple articles actually, on our website, www.pxdocs.com. So pxdocs.com. That is all about the vagus nerve. You'll see tons of stories about kids with everything from seizures to chronic immune challenges to social emotional challenges. The vagus nerve and addressing the subluxation that was holding it back was the key to getting all those kids better. So tag somebody in this video who you know needs to hear this. Share this in your holistic groups. Share it on your socials. Send it, text it, email it, TikTok it to as many of your friends as possible. If you've got any questions about the vagus nerve and you want to learn more about it, reach out to us. Download one of our guides. Get onto one of our webinars. But most importantly, at the end of all that, get into one of the offices of our PX Docs network so you can get these scans and get this HRV analysis, and you can find out exactly where you or your child's vagus nerve is and get a customized vagus nerve neurologically focused recharging plan to get better, to get resilient, to get adaptable, and to get through whatever challenges you or your child may be facing, and even better, stay ahead of them forever forward. I love you. God bless. Be well. Please share. Please like. Please subscribe if you're watching this on YouTube. Please share it. We love you. See you next time.